Once there was this kid who took a trip to Singapore and brought along his spray paint.
Good day, folks. It's Monday, March 9th, 2007. And welcome to Trick's Takeout Triptych Show. I feel like dog shit. Iran has entered a new nuclear phase, President Ahmadinejad announced today, meaning basically that Iran now has the power to produce nuclear fuel on an industrial level. As if tensions weren't strained enough. This announcement coincided with an Iranian holiday, which has, in my opinion, one of the scariest names of any holiday in the world. Nuclear Technology Day. Iran continues to maintain that their nuclear program is entirely 100% peaceful. But, then again, we didn't believe that the first time either. You remember that little tsunami that happened in the Solomon Islands that I was talking about a week ago? And everybody was all like, hooray, only 13 people died. There's one tiny caveat. It left an additional 7,000 homeless. Susan Chippendale, a member of the Red Cross stationed on Gizo Island, has stated that at least 2,000 people have been rendered homeless on Gizo Island alone. And most of those people have had their homes and property entirely destroyed. Cartoonist Johnny Hart, one of the people responsible for bringing us both the comics BC and Wizard of Id, has died at his home, at his storyboard, working on a comic. He was 76. Oddly enough, both comics will continue to be syndicated, seeing as how family members have been helping to create the strips for years, and they have an extensive digital archive of drawings to copy from. Oh, I'm sorry, work from. Charles Schultz is just rolling in his grave going, fuck, why didn't I think of that? Ethiopian opposition leaders that were arrested after the protests and violence involved in the protests following last year's Ethiopian election have finally been acquitted of at least one charge, the one of attempted genocide. An additional 25 that were accused, mostly journalists, publicists, people like that, been completely acquitted of the crimes and freed immediately, even though they've been in jail for the past 15 months, during which time one of them gave birth. The remaining 85 prisoners each face up to 4 accounts, including attempting to overthrow the government through armed struggle and crimes against the Constitution. The charges altogether could carry either death or life in prison. The Queen has unveiled a restored monument to Canadian war heroes in France. Guess which war it was for? If you guessed World War II, sorry, you were wrong. And only two to choose from. Major gas exporting countries have stated that they will form a high-level pricing committee in order to decide, well, the prices of gas. However, they've completely denied any charges that this could become a cartel. The committee is headed up by Russia, and includes other countries such as Iran, Kazakhstan, and Qatar. As far as the UK military goes, apparently the Ministry of Defense has decided to put a complete and total ban on any soldiers of any kind selling their stories to news companies or publishers. This is not nearly as insidious as it seems at first. Supposedly, the ban is only there temporarily, so that rule reviews and changes can be made, so that it is consistent across the entire board. The problem is, a good number of those soldiers recently captured and recently released by the Iranian government, members of the Royal Navy, have decided to sell their stories. However, soldiers that have recently been killed in Iraq or recently served in Iraq are banned from doing so. The Ministry of Defense seeks to solve this problem by making it across the board as to whether or not soldiers shall be banned from selling their stories or not. A recent flaw with Windows has come into light as of late March. Apparently, Windows has a fundamental problem dealing with animated cursors, such as those in games, namely, games like World of Warcraft. So all of you WoW geeks out there, listen closely. Basically, what's happening, as far as I understand it, is that there is a flaw in the coding of the way that Windows handles animated cursors. Hackers can take advantage of this flaw by basically using it like a nick in a suit of armor. When the rest of the system is completely and totally protected, you can get a little crowbar into this nick and pry open and get inside. The reason I mention World of Warcraft is that it has recently come to light that World of Warcraft accounts are actually worth slightly more than credit card accounts. Whereas credit card accounts are basically seen as being worth about $6, a World of Warcraft account can sell for about 10. Who else finds that kind of funny? Microsoft, in an uncharacteristically generous offer, has already released a patch to combat this. Now I got two major things to say right now. Both are to CNNnews.com. First of all, take a look at what the CNN.com front page looks like right now. I'm sorry, CNN, but when you have other news items like Iran announcing this about their nuclear program, Don Imus being suspended from the air for 2 weeks by two different companies is not considered breaking news. The second problem I have with this front page here is this little story down here in the corner. Nine-months pregnant clerk shoots female robin. That sounds like an interesting story to me. Sound like an interesting story to you? Exactly. But I'm not going to tell you about it. Do you know why? Because you see that little icon next to it? I'll show you again, just so you can. That little icon means that you can only view it in video. Is it so damn hard to have a text transcript of this right next to it?
And that's all the news for today, folks.
Bleh.